Very soon, Chelsea will be under new management. And while a lot of people are still jumping for joy at the prospect of Roman Abramovich ending all association with the London Giants, the reality is that the Russian billionaire's forced departure is unlikely to change things at the club, and we'll tell you why that's the case. Manchester United's ownership and senior figures are as confused as they were last year. They still haven't decided who will replace Ralf Rangnick at the dugout for next season. And now, the residents of Old Trafford are looking to hire Carlo Ancelotti, whose job at Real Madrid is under threat. The idea of the new Super League was considered dead last year. However, the chief protagonists are currently trying to revive the controversial plan. But they need to watch out for UEFA president Alexander Čeferin, who isn't going to take it lightly. PSG are not giving up on extending Kylian Mbappe's deal at Parc des Princes, and sporting director Leonardo says that the club will try everything to keep their star player around. Before we get started, we want to share the sponsor of today's video. The OneFootball app is the ultimate football platform and is a must-have for every football fan so that you can follow all of your favorite leagues, teams, and players all the time right from your phone. You can be sure to turn on notifications for specific players to be instantly alerted when they score a goal or when they're involved in other breaking news. It is the best and easiest way to stay up to date with everything football. Click the link in the description down below to download the app right now. You won't regret it. Paris Saint-Germain still believe in it. While Kylian Mbappe's contract expires in June 2022, the capital club still hope to be able to keep him. The speech of Leonardo, the Parisian sports director, in the columns of L'Équipe this Thursday is there to prove it. "As long as there is no signature, we will try everything. We will do everything to keep him," said the Brazilian, judging that the Rouge et Bleu had their possibilities. However, if the former Brazil international wishes to believe it, he denies having sent a new offer to his 2018 world champion. €50 million annually until June 2024 and a signing bonus of €100 million. "That's not true. We haven't sent a specific offer. There is an important element. I think the last thing we will put on this contract will be the amount. We want to put him in the best conditions so that he becomes the best player possible," he said. Considering that money will not be an issue in this matter, Leo took advantage of this interview to send a strong message to his number 7 and remind him of what PSG can continue to do for him. "Now I think Kylian has really big thinking to do. The feeling that there was on Saturday at the stadium is magnificent. Something is being created, not just for him. I'm not here to be slick, but other clubs don't have ultras like that. It carries weight," he explained, also communicating with his supporters before continuing that Mbappe's performances are not going to be judged against Real Madrid. PSG do have an upcoming generation and several great prospects in the academy. Mbappe knows exactly where he is and what he will be leaving if he decides to join Real Madrid. However, we will know exactly what the player wants at the end of this campaign. April 19th, 2021. 12 major European clubs announced the creation of a Super League in Europe. AC Milan, Arsenal, Atletico Madrid, Chelsea, FC Barcelona, FC Internazionale Milano, Juventus FC, Liverpool, Manchester City, Manchester United, Real Madrid and Tottenham joined as founding clubs. Three more clubs will be invited to join ahead of the inaugural season, which will begin as soon as possible, the press release read. But this ambitious project quickly fell through. In the hours or even days that followed, many clubs threw in the towel as they were threatened by both their national federations and UEFA. Some were excluded from the ECA. Finally, Real Madrid, Barcelona and Juventus were the three teams to have insisted until the end to launch the project, a project that was strongly criticized at the time by Alexander Čeferin. The UEFA president had multiplied the threats to the clubs tempted to be a part of this operation. A few months later, Juve, Real Madrid and Barca still haven't given up on the idea of launching this new league. Last week, The Telegraph announced that the three European behemoths had worked on a new formula, where there would be no automatic qualifications, and that they intended to unveil it this Thursday. But that was without counting on Alexander Čeferin, who decided to pull the rug out from under them. On Thursday evening, Čeferin had a lot to get off his chest and spoke about how the three teams are floating the idea once again when the world could be on the brink of war. Then he again threatened clubs thinking of participating as he had done the first time. "I'm tired of talking about this non-football project. Those who want to play in the Super League will not be able to participate in competitions organized by UEFA." The message is clear. Čeferin and UEFA still don't want to hear about this Super League. Under pressure to bring in Mauricio Pochettino since the latter has straightened out his sporting situation at PSG, Manchester United are exploring other avenues to take over from Ralf Rangnick. One of them leads to Carlo Ancelotti. Like what a season is sometimes played on a match or a double confrontation, this is a bit of what Carlo Ancelotti is going through at the moment. Until mid-February, his return to Real Madrid went smoothly. Leader of a La Liga in which their historical rivals Atletico Madrid and Barcelona are no match for the Casablanca, they suffered a major affront, a defeat in the round of 16 first leg of the Champions League against PSG. There are circumstances to be found in this setback. Karim Benzema, for example, was not at his best, returning after 3 weeks without a game. But it is especially in the over-display that doubt has settled in the minds of the management of the club. Ancelotti's team were swept away for 90 minutes and even came off quite well with only a goal down for the second leg. Still difficult to imagine 3 weeks ago, the Italian coach will probably pay the price on March 9th at the Santiago Bernabeu. In the event of premature elimination, he should end the season and leave. His possible future winner of this round of 16, Mauricio Pochettino, is tipped to take over, but he has been linked for weeks with Tottenham, his former club, and especially at Man United. The Argentinian never seemed to find his feet at PSG, where he is out of contract in 2023, but the end of the season could change the situation. The Red Devils are preparing for a possible turnaround, and according to information from The Times, they have made Ancelotti one of their candidates to take over from interim Rangnick. Competing with Erik ten Hag of Ajax, the Italian knows the Premier League well, having led Chelsea between 2009 and 2011, and Everton between 2019 and 2021. He would even find a certain Cristiano Ronaldo for a tandem that worked perfectly at Real Madrid between 2013 and 2015. It was a real thunderclap that fell on Chelsea last week with the press release from Roman Abramovich. The Russian billionaire formalised the rumour and announced that he was selling Chelsea. Consequence of the war led by Russia in Ukraine and his acquaintance with Vladimir Putin. In an attempt to restore his image and not leave England with a black eye, he announced to pay off the debt of the London club, estimated at €1.8 billion, and distribute the profits from the sale to the victims of the war. The future of Chelsea put up for sale at a price of €3.6 billion after an initial purchase price of €190 million seems in any case assured, despite this total reversal of the situation. Abramovich leaves the stage through the small door. The current opinion has turned against Abramovich and everything he stands for. He had become the inaccessible absent owner, accountable to no one, with an unbroken streak of 19 years without giving a single interview about his motives or intentions, the Daily Telegraph said. Chelsea fans will look back on the last 19 years with a certain nostalgia, and the players who have symbolised this era will surely ignore the geopolitical context, like John Terry, who posted on his social networks, "Thank you, Roman, best owner in the world." Since then, a lot of billionaires have been linked with acquiring the London club. Wies Hansjörg, one of Switzerland's wealthiest men, is interested in Chelsea. The London club is up for sale. Its legendary owner hopes to separate from his club when possible sanctions could hit him hard because of his supposed proximity to Putin. One of the people likely to buy Chelsea reveals himself and sets his conditions. And it appears that Hansjörg is in pole position to buy the club alongside OGC Nice owner Sir Jim Ratcliffe. The Nice owner is the wealthiest man from Britain and was linked with the move as well. However, the billionaire has distanced himself from the rumours. Nonetheless, there is a certain bit of anxiety around the entire process, since a change of ownership could mean something very bad for the club in a sporting sense. There are fears that the Blues might not be as competitive as they were under the Abramovich era. Indeed, the Russian poured money into the club and literally bought them success. Will the new owners share the same ideals? And this is what's going to be interesting to see. Once there's a change in ownership, we, at Goalside, plan to do a deep dive into the new owners, their history, and see how they will use the club, as an asset that they could sell for a fortune later on, or as a pet project to appease themselves like Abramovich did.